anybody that's fighting with these guys, they're ready to go tonight.
Yep.
They're not here messing around. So.
And Martinez is just dialed in. He hasn't stopped staring across the cage the entire time.
He hasn't. It's just a...
This is our first experience here where one guy's got cage time, the other one doesn't, so we'll see how that plays out. It's one of those where Vazquez has got to get in there and he's got to land that early shot. Give him some confidence. There you go. Vazquez is real light on his feet. That's what I was gonna say. It looked Martinez the way he was approaching. It looked like he really wants to get the grappling, the takedown.
Yeah. Nice front kick.
Ooh.
Nice right hand.
And good job by Martinez to weather that. I mean, he's mounted, but at least, I mean, he's given himself a chance. And Martinez has one win via the submission. This probably where he wants to be at, and here he is. He's got the back. What a turn of events here.
Yeah, this is
Martinez. He's trying to sink that other. Doesn't have that other leg in yet. No, he does have a other leg in. He's got his hooks in. Now he's just going to sit here and fight for that rear naked.
It's getting tight. He's just. Yeah. Fights it.
Vazquez doing a good job fighting the hands.
That's what he needs to do there, is just fight the hands here. But this is going to be a tough spot to. It's going to be a tough spot to get out of.
Martinez got him flattened out now too.
Oh, he's got some air. He's got some air.
It's impressive, both these guys' tenacity as far as in these scrambles. He's got to continue to fight that hand. That right arm is under the chin.
He needs to weather this. He just needs to pull on that hand and get his chin.
Oh, it's tight now. This is
right.
He's doing a good job fighting the hand still. This is a tough spot to be in when you're feeling your throat collapse like that, and you're having to fight through this. It's just a tough spot to be in. Might be able to slip out the back door here.
Yep, he needs it. He's got 10 seconds.
Nice reversal.
Ends in a good spot. Good for him. Wow, he was in trouble there. That was tight.
This is gonna. How do you score
that?
That
was tight. I'm surprised that right hand didn't hurt him a little bit more in the beginning, and just being where they were at there. Aaron, I thought he was in a lot of trouble there.
I think he was. It looked like as soon as he hit the mat, Vazquez got on top of him. It looked like he just went into survival mode. You know, you train for that, where you get super gassed out or whatever, and you just have to learn how to fight through that. And I think he was pretty hurt with that right hand. He just did a really good job of fighting through it and being able to get into a position he was comfortable with and be able to fight back in that round. Tough round to score just because both guys were in trouble. In serious trouble.
That could have gone either way.
Yep.
I don't know.
That's one of those rounds where the judges' scorecards might be split on that round. You know, two of them might have it for one guy, and one guy might have it for the other guy. Martinez rushes back to the center again. Vazquez has got real good movement, considering it's his debut fight. He's real light on his feet.
Nice body kick.
And that's, his movement's very good because he's able to fluidly move around and still be able to throw a shot.
Yeah, side to side.
Yep.
Ooh, nice uppercut there too. Yes,
nice knee to the body.
There's a nice knee to the body. I was going to say, I would be going more for the body there. He's just, there's opportunities there.
Martinez does kind of hold his hands up high.
Oh, another right hand. Caught him.
It's a brutal feeling when you get rocked like that. Just... Looks like he's spinning here, trying to go for potentially.
He's throwing up a triangle.
Yep.
Now he's got a knock.
Yeah, Martinez is definitely, he does a lot of jiu-jitsu. We'll just put it that way. That's because of the mountain out of the back.
This is a good spot to be in for him, and just kind of hold on and gather my thoughts here for a second here. Is this where I want to be? You know, if we get if there's going to be a scramble, am I better off going to my feet and not being on the ground with the guy that's throwing up submissions, you know?
No, if you're gonna be on the ground with somebody who likes throwing submissions, it's better to be on his back, for sure.
Yep.
He's got both hooks in. He's got the, looked like he had the rear naked there if he wanted it, but he didn't really squeeze it. Trying to get under the chin here again.
Way to switch his hips and come up back on top. Now if he can just swivel his hips, I guess, yep, now he's going to come back out. No, you got to get to your feet there.
Scramble there. And now you wonder how Martinez feels. I mean, he's been dropped twice now.
He's got to keep his hands up.
That was a good kick to the body. I know Martinez kind of caught it, but that still hurts, though. I think that one was definitely Vazquez.
I do, too. I definitely think so. I think this fight's pretty close.
I really just want to know how the first round was scored. But this, again, this is another one of those fights where, I mean, you're in either one of these corners and you got to be saying, you got to go this round.
If I'm blue corner, I'm telling them we got to get a takedown and be on top somehow, one way or the other.
Yep.
We don't want to be on our, if I'm red corner, I'm saying let's be patient, but let's be aggressive and let's find that shot again.
Yep.
Let's pick him apart here.
If you put him back
on his butt again with another right hand, that's a whole other story here. There's three knockdowns in the fight. So, depends on, I mean, obviously their corners know their fighters more than we do here, but that's, and from just judging in the last, 6 minutes, it's probably 1-1.
Yep.
Probably.
And if you're blue corner, checking Martinez out here. Just giving a double check, making sure he's good. He must have saw a wobble when he stood up.
And if you're a smart fighter, too, I'm just saying it as the way it is. Like, now I'm the red corner. I see that. Like, okay, they see something. Now I'm going in. Now my right hand's, as a fighter, you got to pay attention to those things, what's happening. But Martinez. Here comes Martinez, and he's fired
forward. Yeah, and that's, you were talking about corners too. If I was in blue corner, I'd be telling him, you know, work for that takedown, but be smart with it, because you can tell Martinez is a little tired. So you obviously don't want to waste a ton of energy on a takedown you can't complete.
Him rushing forward like this is dangerous, though, with that right hand that's already dropped him a few times. So
yep,
got to be careful, because it's going to... He's pressing on that takedown.
You see, this is one of those things, it's like, this is going to be a tough takedown to complete, but he was able to get in there and get the double. I think this is important to determine what's going to happen in this round as far as the judges go, because who's going to be able to win this battle right here?
Martinez has to do is just, I mean, realistically, just stay on top and stay active.
Yep.
And he wins the round, which, I mean,
and
but you know, I don't know. I always have a hard time with this because this is, there's not a lot going on here in these amateur fights. Like, 30 seconds goes by and we're still in full guard.
Yep.
And it's a tight. I mean, this is where the referee, I could say, hey, get these guys back on the feet. Yep. You know, like, that's where they want to be anyway. I mean, well, bottom guy does, but you know what I mean? I don't know. But I get it. I understand.
Yeah.
I understand how to win and score points, though, too. Yeah, our crowd wants everybody to be on their feet here, but.
Martinez is landing some shots here.
Yeah, he's doing his job. He's staying on top and he's staying busy.
He did a good job of controlling.
I mean, none of those shots are damaging. It's, I mean, I don't think.
A couple of them are open palm, it looked like. He did a good job of grabbing Vazquez's left leg, pushing it down. He was able to get into that half guard there. He's almost in the mount here. He's trying to slip that left there. He's got the mount. Oh, right as the round ends. So
yeah.
Martinez wins that round. So, and this could be interesting. You could actually end up seeing a split decision in this just based on how the first round was judged. But we'll see. Like the primal MKE, like their catchphrase that's on all their shorts, embrace the chaos.
It is interesting because there was two knockdowns though too. You know, I mean,
true.
Two right hands that.
Well, I think Vazquez won the second round regardless.
Right, but in that first round he knocked him down. That's, I don't know.
But then Martinez had him in deep trouble with that rear naked choke for probably over a minute maybe of that round. So it's kind of, that's what I mean. It's like, how do you judge that first round? It'll be interesting to see how the judges scored that first round on it. It must have been that rear naked choke in the first round. He had him in danger, and they just valued that more than the knockdown.
Dillan was surprised himself there, thinking that he didn't, you know, do enough.
It's tough, man. Like,
I don't know. I mean,
I
I don't disagree with him being shocked either, because I mean, I look at it like this. In the third rounder, yes, he did his job. He took him down. He's on top, but like there was but two knockdowns. The knockdown in the first,
yeah,
I feel should always outscore just a takedown on top. But I think he did his I can go either way, because he did his job. He stayed busy.
Yeah.
And I'm going back and forth here, but
he was definitely in more trouble in the first round with that right hand than he was in the second round. So it's like, that's what I mean. It's tough. You gotta. It just comes down to what the judges.
Yeah.
Feels more important. And
either way,
good fight. Good fight.
Good fight. Guys. They go both go back, and I apologize. I got their names mixed up in the beginning there.
No, that's okay.
I was looking at the wrong guy when I, for a second there, I thought Martinez might have been. I looked down and I thought it was. Said he might have been related there to Felipe, but I got the guys wrong there. So I apologize to both fighters there for mixing that up there.